Welcome back to another episode of Askjerry.
Thanks, Gabby. It should be a really great show today.
What are we going to get into?
Today, I finally want to get to the point where we start going in and making some changes to the user interface to add special features. Now, Gabby, you've got a lot of experience with CNC and stuff like that. As I remember correctly, you do a lot with 3D printers, so you should be familiar with some of the technology, yeah?
I don't know much about LinuxCNC, but I'd like to learn.
Well, that's great. I guess we should get started.
We want to create a panel that will allow us to move the milling machine around smoothly without having to use the existing controls on the left of the screen. The new panel should allow movement with a simple click of the mouse without having to first click on an axis selector. The panel should be easy to read, well organized, and simple to use for even the most inexperienced user. The control consists of a label at the top, buttons to move the x-axis left and right, buttons to move the y-axis forward and backward, buttons to move the z-axis up and down. We'll also need a method to set the feed rate from slow to fast, depending on what we want. The two main tools that we'll use to create the basic form of our panel are V-box, vertical box, and H-box, horizontal box. The box is simply a container. It tells LinuxCNC how to handle multiple items or widgets that we wish to stick into a grouping. Assume that we wish to drop in three buttons. Here is how each container would handle them. The H box places them horizontally. The V box places them vertically. Looking at our panel design, you can see that we have several items arranged vertically with some sets arranged horizontally. We can create a V-box that contains three sets of H-boxes. Once the V-box is defined, we can create the first component, the label. With the label defined, we can install the H-box containers, which will stack vertically because these reside inside the initial V-box we created earlier. These will then be populated with the individual buttons we require. And you'll notice that they do go horizontally because they're in the H box. The last component is actually made of two parts, another label and a scale. We can drop both of these after the last H box, and they will stack vertically because we're still inside of the original V box container. The actual code for this control panel looks like this. It may look a bit intimidating at first, but it really is not that difficult if you add one component at a time and test each one to be sure it displays properly. These are the minimum commands for the items. There are more parts to the widget, such as font size, foreground color, background color, etc.
Lots of different widgets are available for use in your custom panel. Below are some of the most common types used. In addition to the basic widgets, there are some really useful ways to display information, control events, and change the visual appearance of the panel. The first component in our panel is a label. The code to create a label is fairly simple, consisting of a header, a footer, and some code in the middle. We can make it more presentable by defining a foreground and background color. Okay. I have opened up GEdit, and in GEdit I have our custom panel XML, and as you can see there's not a whole lot in there. So the first thing we want is we want a V-box, and we need to close the V-box. Now one of the things I like to do is I'll indent the different things, highlight them and hit the tab key. It helps you keep track of what's nested in what. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to insert a label, and the label will need a close. Now, how does it know that it's a start and it's a close? Well, it's very important that we put these slashes in here. See how the pyVCP has one? That tells it start, stop, start, stop. All right. Now what we'll do is inside of our label, we'll throw some text. And as you might guess, it's also going to need a stop. Okay. Now, what text are we going to put in there? Let's just say hello. And you notice it is inside of quotation marks. So we'll save this. Pick another window here, and we'll start up our Frankenlabs. Now you notice it started, and you notice we've got an itty-bitty little label over here that says hello. It proves that it works. Not exactly great looking, but it proves that it works. Let's make it a little bit better. Back inside of GEdit, we'll add this line. All this is a font. It tells it Helvetica is a very common font. You'll see it a lot. And we just pick the size of 20. Let's see how that looks. We'll hit save. That's all we'll do. Come in here and open up Frankenlabs. And you see now the text is a lot bigger. Still doesn't look wonderful and great, but you know, you get the idea. Now let's tweak it a little bit more. Let's add some color to it. Back into GEdit. Now, there is a command called FG, and FG is for foreground color. Then what we do is we put the actual foreground color, and you put a number sign like that, and that tells it that the following is going to be a hexadecimal number. White is FF for the red, FF for the green, FF for the blue. Alright, that's the maximum amount of brightness that you can have. And then we will close that with another FG for foreground color. Okay? Now, let's throw a background color in there too, which is, can you guess? BG for background. And in this case, we will make it black. Black is the absence of all colors, so no red, no green, no blue. And we will close it. Alright, and we will save it. Now, let's see what that looks like. Restart Frankenlabs, and hey, look at that, we've got a great looking label now with hello on there, and it's black and all that kind of good stuff. So we'll do one more quick tweak. I don't think we need quite as large as 20 pitch. 16 is probably going to do it. And let's call it what we're actually going to call it, which is main. And we will save this, reopen Frankenlabs. And you see now we've got our nice big, in fact it's still a little too big, we'll go a little bit smaller yet. And this is the thing, you got to tweak on these. I'm thinking 12 is probably going to be the right size. It takes a little getting used to. You'll get it. You'll have to play with it. Yeah, I like that. 12 works. That's going to be our title. We'll start throwing some buttons in now. That'll spread it out, and we'll make some other changes to it. If you go and do a Google search on LinuxCNC pyVCP, you'll end up on this page. And this page is all the instructions on how to do all this stuff. Basically, this is where I'm getting the data for this video. Now let's skip ahead, go over here to containers. And if you'll notice this guy right here, there's flat, which is how our label looks right now, sunken, raised, groove, and ridge. So these are all different styles, and they all have a border thickness that you can add. So let's go and take a look at that. We'll come in here to our label, and I'll insert these two lines. The first line is relief, and that tells it what type. And you can see that I picked raised. Okay, and then we've got a border width of 6. So I'll save that. Come in here and open up Frankenlabs. And you see it's made a change here. It's got this border. Now that's a little bit, you know, too gaudy for the way I like it, but it's to show you what it looks like. So we'll come back in here and we can change this to say, let's say 2, which isn't quite so bad. Come back in here and you can instantly see the effect that it's going to make. And you see there's a border now, but it's not, you know, crazy. So you can fiddle with that and you can make different looks and make it a lot more aesthetically pleasing. So let's go ahead and add some more functionality now. Okay, now things are going to get a little bit crazy. Remember, inside of this vertical box, we wanted to add some other boxes. So we're going to do an H box, which stacks things horizontally, right? And that's like this. Then inside of there, we're going to put some buttons. Now I'm going to just steal one real quick off of a panel that I already did, just to get us going, because there's a lot of typing here and I know this video is getting long as it is. So in the button, in addition to having your text and your foreground and background colors, you can throw this line in there, and that means that you can wrap text, which means you can have multiple lines. Okay? This slash N means new line. This is all stuff I discovered and I'm passing it along to you. So what we're going to have is the first button is going to have X minus, and then in a new line it's going to have the word left. So when we mash that button, it'll go to the left. There's going to be a pin, a HAL pin. That's a user interface pin, and we're going to call it X minus. So when we get into the next section, the next video, you'll see how we can link this with an actual command. Other than that, it's very similar to a label. We've got our font, we've got a width, which tells it how many characters we're going to allow, and then we're going to throw some padding in there. And this is all stuff I derived by messing around with this thing to get the button to work right. I'm going to save this single button in the H box here and fire up Frankenlabs. And you see we've made this one nice pretty button. It's got a color and it's got X left and all that good stuff, and you see how this stretched out to fit, right? All that wonderful stuff happening. Now what we'll do is we'll go in here and I'll put in what I really did, which is all of this fun stuff, and we'll drop it in instead of just this H box here. So don't let the size of this scare you. It's still our label. We've got an H box. I put a comment. These are comments here. They don't do anything, but they help you to remember what you did when you come back to it 6 months later. So here's our X jog buttons, and you see there's a button. There's another button, and then there's an H box. And if we want to, we can indent these if it helps you to visualize them a little bit more. Just like this. The colors, I went online and looked up some HTML colors and found some colors that I liked. I basically went with a red, green, blue theme. So if I save this and we go into our Frankenlabs now, ta-da, you get these nice big buttons. And don't be afraid to experiment. You're not going to hurt it at this point. Get it the way you want it to look. Next we'll throw in our last label and our scale, and then we'll have all the components that we need for the panel, and that'll be enough for this video. In the next video we'll actually make it do something. Okay. So, you know, we've got the buttons in here, and as we stated, this is the last horizontal box. We're still inside of the V box. So now what we'll do is we'll throw our label in there. Nothing fancy there. Same Helvetica size 12, foreground color white, background color black, and you can change these. Then we have a scale. And a scale is a little slidey thing that lets you input information. And the pin that we're going to assign this to is jog speed. We'll get to that in the next video. You can orient it horizontally or vertically. Vertically wouldn't make much sense here, so horizontal. The resolution is, as you move the slider, how fast it increments. So if I put in a resolution of 0.1, it would go in increments of 0.1, which isn't really going to make a lot of sense to us. I'm actually going to set this thing at a resolution of 10. So now it will go from a minimum. Let's set the minimum from, you're not really going to run less jog speed, less than, say, 50 millimeters. That's it would be kind of slow below that. So we'll say a jog speed of 50 to 2500, let's say. And we'll say start it off at 1000. Okay? Do all that. Save it. And let's open it up in Frankenlab and see what it actually looks like. And now you see we've got a really good panel. It's got left and right buttons. Backward and forward, up and down, and it's got a jog speed that we can move from 50 to 2500. Now, of course, right now they don't do anything. And the reason they don't do anything is we haven't made any connections. I'll give you a little quick sneak peek. If we go into HAL configuration, you're going to see there's all kinds of pins and components and all that kind of stuff. And if you look here, there's pyVCP. And these are what we defined in our code so far. We've got a jog speed, a plus, a minus, and all of these kind of things. And if I set this thing to watch, for example, and I click on jog speed, you see how it has the jog speed right here? I'll move that down. And as I actually slide this, you see it's changing. So the panel's actually sending information. It's just that we haven't told it what to do. Now that we've got the basic panel built, our next step is to make it actually do something. Stay tuned in the next video, we'll cover that, and eventually we'll get it to look like this one. See you on the next video.